أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون
فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمداً عبده ورسوله. اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد في الأولين وفي الآخرين وفي الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, this is Imam Karim Abu Zaid coming live on our page One Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, and answering one of the questions which keeps coming back. Someone intentionally did not fast multiple Ramadans in the past because of ignorance, because of being negligent, because of he was not committed to Islam, because he was heedless, he didn't know the gravity of deliberately breaking fast during the month of Ramadan. And alhamdulillah, this person has repented. He realized the mistake that he has made, and he is willing to fix that. What should he do, or what should she do to repair that? Brothers and sisters in Islam, fasting Ramadan is a pillar of Islam. So it is mandatory upon every Muslim who is in a state of sanity, reach the state of puberty. He is not excused by the Sharia that would include sickness or traveling, the distance where a Muslim is entitled to shorten the Salah. And regarding the sisters, you know, they are clear of the period, the cycle. And we can add the pregnant and the elder, Shaykh wa Shaykha wa al-Hamil wa al-Murda, and the breastfeeding sisters. These are legitimate excuses in the Sharia. The people who are old, and that old age is combined with not being able to exercise the pillar of fasting. So these are legitimate excuses in the Sharia. Now, if you broke your fast with no excuse, then that is tremendous in Islam. وورد في حديث, it was authentically transmitted in الحديث حسنه الشيخ الألباني في السنن, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saw individuals hanging upside down from their ankles in hell. And Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم asked جبرائيل عليه السلام, من هؤلاء يا جبريل؟ He said عليه السلام to رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, هؤلاء الذين يفطرون قبل تحلة, يفطرون رمضان, يعني that's the meaning. Those who intentionally do not fast or break, actually they fast and they break fast before the time without any excuse. First of all, this brother or this sister who have done this, they must remorse, they must regret. And we know regretfulness is the cornerstone of the act of repentance. Because before they consider what they can do to repair this, internally they have to repent. And I hope these brothers and these sisters are no longer seeing what they have done okay. Imagine, this is a pillar of Islam. بُنِيَ الْإِسْلَامُ عَلَىٰ خَمْسٍ. Islam is built on five pillars, and one of these pillars is صوم رمضان. Imagine having a broken pillar in a house. You're not going to live in this house. You're going to leave that house. There is a danger here. And yes, there is an extensive writing regarding a Muslim who does not pray. But when time came and the Muslims did not pay the zakah, certain Muslims who accepted Islam recently and they decided not to pay the zakah, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq decided to wage war against them, because this is a pillar of Islam too. And he said, I will challenge anyone who separate the salah from the zakah. Shahid, brothers and sisters in Islam, the message that I'm trying to is the feeling of guilt for doing this. Yes, if you're sick, Allah giving you a license. No one can even talk to you about it. If you have an excuse, but you intentionally, because you don't care, so you must regret this. So this is step number one. And what we mean by regretfulness is a tawbah. And a tawbah with the conditions. You do this sincerely, not because the people are going to remind you and you need to make it up in order to tell them, I made it up now, you don't have to remind me of it. No, it's between you and Allah. Sincerity for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Regretting doing this. Of course, in the present, abandoning to do this, and how you abandon here, by not breaking fast anymore without an excuse again, that you never commit that sin again, unless you have an excuse. That's another issue. Unless if you're sick, you're traveling, that's another issue. Vow not to go back to it in the future. So that's one three. Vow not to go back to it in the future. And alhamdulillah, the fact of the matter that they are asking, that means the guilt is there. We don't want to be harsh on them, But what should they do? The question here regarding the days which they have missed. Two opinions. The majority of the jurists, of the scholars, have ruled that they have to track these days back. They have to trace it. They have to figure out what was the age of puberty and how many Ramadan did they miss, and they need to make up these days. And this is the majority. And actually, there is a consensus on this opinion amongst a scholarly consensus. We don't have an evidence. And that hadith which says that whoever breaks fast intentionally without excuse in Ramadan, even if he fasts the whole time, the whole year, all of his life, he's not going to be able to make up this day, that's wrong. That is not correct. Because even the individuals who did intercourse during the time of the Prophet ﷺ, which one of the nullifiers of fasting, when they came back to the Prophet ﷺ, he showed them that there is an expiation and there is a way to make tawbah. So that hadith is not correct, is not authentic, is not established. So there is an opinion out there that if they are able to go back and find out how many days were missed and they need to make up these days, and this is the safest opinion. The safest opinion. Now, there is another opinion out there. If it is too much, then tawbah would be sufficient. This is number one. And number two, and with the tawbah, of course, with the act of tawbah, that they never go back to committing this sin again. They never go back to committing this sin again, meaning they never go back to breaking fast again. But at the same time, they should fast as many voluntary nawafil as possible. Mondays, Thursdays, 3 days out of the month. So they should increase their nawafil fasting. Hopefully this will take care of the mandatory fasting. And how did these scholars base this opinion on? Qiyasan ala salah, using analogy with the salah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us that the first thing that a Muslim will be asked about in the day of judgment will be the salah. If it is accepted, then the rest of the deeds will be accepted. وفي حديث that says what? انظروا إلى النوافل. انظروا إلى التطوع. Look at the voluntary salah. In order to do what? In order to لجبر الفريضة. In order to make up for the missed salah from, even though the opinion is not the missed salah, actually the salah which they prayed but they did not get the full reward. Because there is an opinion out there that the salah, if you miss the time without an excuse, either you can't make it up. So I don't want to confuse you here, but the second opinion, if it is too much or you cannot trace it back, then make tawbah, never go back to it at all, but do as many voluntary fasting as possible. Hopefully this will take care of the mandatory. جزاكم الله خيرا سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك والحمد لله رب العالمين ورمضان مبارك to all of you. Inshallah, we'll try to come every night to answer one of these questions which are repeated. I received that question from 5-6 people already, and alhamdulillah I was able to answer it. Jazakumullah khaira. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.